Friends, in last period, we have seen the enthalpies of physical changes. Enthalpies of physical changes, there are four types of enthalpies of physical changes. Out of that four types of physical enthalpies of physical changes, we have seen the first type of enthalpy of physical changes, that is enthalpy of phase transition. Enthalpy of phase transition is again subclassified into three types. Number one, enthalpy of vaporization, enthalpy of sublimation, and enthalpy of solution. Then, second type of enthalpies of physical changes is enthalpies of atomic or molecular changes. Second type of enthalpies of physical changes is enthalpies of atomic or molecular changes. This enthalpy of atomic or molecular changes again subclassified into two types. That is, first is enthalpy of atomization, which is represented by symbol delta H ATO. ATO means atomization. It is defined as the enthalpy change required when one mole of a gaseous substance dissociated or breaks into its free atoms or radicals. Or it is defined as the enthalpy change takes place when one mole of a gaseous substance breaks up or dissociated into its free atoms or radicals is called as enthalpy of atomization. याचा अर्थ असा होतो की इन एन्थाल्पी ऑफ ॲटोमायझेशन, कोणताही एक गॅसेसचा मॉलिक्यूल घ्यायचा आणि त्याला हीट सप्लाय करायची. हीट सप्लाय केल्यानंतर त्या गॅसेस मॉलिक्यूलमध्ये जे दोन तीन ॲटम असतील विच आर कोव्हॅलेंटली बॉन्डेड, तो कोव्हॅलेंट बॉन्ड ब्रेक होऊन त्यांचे फ्री ॲटम किंवा फ्री गॅसियस रॅडिकल्स फॉर्म होतात. फॉर एक्झाम्पल हिअर हायड्रोजन गॅस इन विच two hydrogen atoms covalently bonded with each other, that covalent bond between two hydrogen atoms dissociated or breaks up to form two hydrogen atoms. At that time, energy is required, that required energy is called as enthalpy of atomization, and this value for hydrogen molecule is 436 kilojoule per mole. During this atomization process, the temperature and pressure is maintained constant. Therefore, it is the enthalpy change required to break a covalent bond in a gaseous molecule to form its free atoms or radicals at constant temperature and pressure, that is called as enthalpy of atomization. The second example of enthalpy of atomization is chlorine gas, in which two chlorine atoms covalently bonded with each other, that covalent bond between the two chlorine atoms dissociated or breaks by supplying the heat to form two chlorine gaseous atoms. The required heat, which is represented by positive sign, is 242 kilojoule per mole. Therefore, the enthalpy of atomization of hydrogen molecule is 436 kilojoule per mole, and enthalpy of atomization of chlorine molecule is 242 kilojoule per mole. From this we can say that enthalpy of atomization is only endothermic process because heat is absorbed. The second type of enthalpy of atomic or molecular changes is enthalpy of ionization, which is represented by delta H ION. Here, in 11th science, we have seen the periodic table. In periodic table, there is also same definition, enthalpy of ionization. It is the enthalpy change required or enthalpy required or heat required to remove most loosely bounded electron from the outermost energy level of gaseous atom to form its gaseous cation is called as enthalpy of ionization. एखाद्या वायुरूप ऍटमच्या शेवटच्या कक्षेमधून इलेक्ट्रॉन बाहेर काढण्यासाठी लागणारी उष्णता त्याला म्हणायचं एन्थाल्पी ऑफ आयनायझेशन. इट इज द एन्थाल्पी चेंज रिक्वायर्ड टू रिमूव एन इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम द आउटरमोस्ट एनर्जी लेवल ऑफ gaseous atom to form a gaseous ion, particularly gaseous cation at constant temperature and pressure. That is called as enthalpy of ionization. म्हणून म्हटलं की 11वी सायन्सला पिरियॉडिक टेबल चॅप्टर मध्ये ही स्टेटमेंट झालेली आहे. Here the example of enthalpy of ionization. Sodium gas is converted into Na plus gas plus electron. Delta H ionization is equal to plus 494 kilojoule per mole. Here it means that to remove the electron from the outermost energy level of sodium gas, 494 kilojoule energy is required. This is also called as first ionization enthalpy, that is delta H 1 ion. First ionization enthalpy means first electron removed from the sodium atom. But when we want to remove the second electron from Na plus gas to form Na2 plus gas plus electron, that is called as delta H ionization second. This delta H ionization second, it is also called as second IP, is greater than the first IP for any atom, because here first IP of sodium, we are removing the 11th electron, that is first IP. Then when we want to remove the electron from Na plus gas, here we are removing the 10th electron. This 10th electron in a sodium ion is near to the nucleus and is paired with another electron. But the 11th electron in Na gas is unpaired and which is away from the nucleus. Therefore, to remove the first electron from the outermost energy level of sodium gas, less amount of energy required. And when we want to remove the second electron from the outermost energy level of Na gas, that second electron is paired and near to the nucleus. Therefore, second ionization enthalpy is more than the first ionization enthalpy. Then third type of enthalpy of physical changes is enthalpy of solution, that is delta H solution. खूप सोपा आहे. तुम्ही कोणताही सॉलिड पदार्थ घ्या आणि तो पाण्यामध्ये टाका. मग पाण्यामध्ये टाकत असताना मग तुम्हाला तो पाण्यामध्ये जर डिझॉल्व करायचा असेल तर तुम्ही स्टर करणार. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, तुम्ही ग्लासामध्ये पाणी घेतलं काचेच्या आणि त्याच्यामध्ये साखर टाकली किंवा सोडियम क्लोराईड मीठ टाकलं तर ते डिझॉल्व करण्यासाठी तुम्हाला स्टर करावं लागेल. स्टर करायले म्हणजे इनडायरेक्टली वी आर सप्लाईंग द हीट. दॅट हीट is called as enthalpy of solution. It is the enthalpy change required when one mole of a solute completely dissolved into a specified quantity of solvent so as to form a solution of particular concentration called as enthalpy of solution. It is the enthalpy change takes place when 1 mole of pure solid substance is dissolved into a given quantity of solvent to form a solution of particular concentration. To dissolve the given quantity of solute into the given quantity of solvent to form a solution of particular concentration, heat is supplied. That supplied heat is called as enthalpy of solution. Here, for example, 1 mole of solid NaCl dissolved into given quantity of water, that is aqueous, to form a aqueous solution of NaCl with particular concentration. To dissolve 1 mole of NaCl solid into given quantity of solvent to form a solution of particular concentration, heat is supplied. That supplied heat is 4 kilojoule per mole. That 4 kilojoule per mole or 4 kilojoule of energy is required to dissolve 1 mole of solid NaCl into the given quantity of solvent to form a solution of particular concentration. This dissolution of solid, pure solid, into a specified quantity of solvent is depend upon the 3 type of intermolecular interaction. See again, the dissolution of solid substance into a specified quantity of solvent depend upon the 3 types of intermolecular interaction. The first type is, see here, the exact value of delta H solution depend upon 3 types of interaction, that is intermolecular interaction. First is solute-solute interaction. Second is solvent-solvent interaction. And third is solute-solvent interaction. Out of these 3, 2 are important. That is first solute-solute interaction and third solute-solvent interaction. Solvent-solvent interaction, for example, solvent is water. To overcome the forces between the water molecule, very less or minimum amount of energy is required. Therefore, this solvent-solvent interaction is neglected. Then we see the first intermolecular interaction, that is solute-solute interaction. Solute-solute interaction means in a solid crystalline substance, the solid particles in crystalline substance are strongly bonded with each other. To overcome these forces between the solid particle, energy is required. That required energy is called as lattice energy or lattice enthalpy. What is lattice enthalpy? It is the energy required to overcome or to break the intermolecular forces of attraction between the solid particles when the solid is dissolved into the aqueous medium. Solute-solute interaction means energy required to overcome the forces between the solid particles. That is called as crystal lattice enthalpy, which is represented by symbol delta HL. For example, here the solid MX. M means here metal and X means non-metal. MX solid dissociated into M plus gas plus x minus gas. Actual example, when NaCl solid dissociated into Na plus gas plus Cl minus gas, at that time energy is required. That required energy is represented by symbol delta EHL, that is crystal lattice enthalpy, and it is always positive, that is plus 790 kilojoule per mole. Then third type of interaction is solute solvent interaction. आता हा तिसरा प्रकार डायरेक्ट का घेतला, दुसरा का नाही घेतला सॉल्वंट सॉल्वंट इंटरॅक्शन? इथं आपलं सॉल्वंट म्हणलं की वॉटर मॉलिक्युल. समजा तुम्ही बकेटमध्ये पाणी घेतलं, तर पाणी म्हणजे तिथं फक्त काय असणार? वॉटर मॉलिक्युल. मग त्या वॉटर मॉलिक्युलमध्ये किंवा बकेटमध्ये तुम्ही हात घालून पाहिला तर तुमचा हात सहज पाण्यामध्ये जाईल. म्हणजे सॉल्वंट सॉल्वंट मॉलिक्युलमध्ये इंटरॅक्शन फोर्सेस फार स्ट्रॉंग नसतात, किंवा ते तुम्हाला ब्रेक करण्यासाठी फार जास्त एनर्जी लागत नाही, म्हणून आपण इथं सॉल्वंट सॉल्वंट इंटरॅक्शन गृहित धरलेलं नाहीये. म्हणून आपण पहिल्यानंतर तिसरा प्रकार घेतला, ती सोल्यूट सॉल्वंट इंटरॅक्शन. इट मीन्स दॅट वेन द सोल्यूट इज ॲडेड इन टू सॉल्वंट, द इंटरॅक्शन बिटवीन सॉल्वंट पार्टिकल अँड सोल्यूट पार्टिकल, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज solute solvent interaction. The interaction of solvent molecules with solute particles is called as solvation. उदाहरणार्थ NaCl common salt घेतला किंवा crystalline sugar घेतली तुम्ही पाण्यामध्ये टाकणार, मग ते सोल्यूट पार्टिकल आणि सॉल्वंट पार्टिकल ह्या दोघांमध्ये जे इंटरॅक्शन असेल त्या इंटरॅक्शनलाच म्हटलेलं आहे सॉल्वेशन. For solvent water, it is the hydration process and energy liberated is enthalpy of hydration, which is represented by delta H HYD, and it is always negative. For example, here this M raised to M plus means from the solid MX, M raised to M plus plus X water molecule. Formation of MH2O taken to the base X power M raised to N plus. Delta HYD is negative. This process is called as hydration process and the enthalpy or energy is given out. Therefore, this value is always negative. During this hydration process, the crystalline ion of solid particle are surrounded by water molecules and get stabilized. That is called as seeding effect. And during this process, heat is given out and the evolved heat is called as enthalpy of hydration. For example, here Na plus plus XH2O. Formation of NaH2O taken X to the power plus 1. Delta H is negative, that is minus 786 kilojoule per mole. But here the enthalpy of solution is the summation of crystal lattice enthalpy and hydration enthalpy. Here solvent solvent entropy enthalpy is added, but this value is very small, therefore neglected. Delta H solution is equal to delta HL, that is crystal lattice enthalpy, plus HYD, delta HYD, that is hydration enthalpy. Crystal lattice enthalpy is 790 kilojoule per mole and hydration enthalpy is minus 786 kilojoule per mole, and 790 minus 786, that gives plus 4 kilojoule per mole. Therefore, when one mole of common salt dissolved into specified quantity of water, 4 kilojoule of energy is required. That energy is called as enthalpy of solution. This enthalpy of solution is positive, the process is endothermic. And when the enthalpy of solution is negative, this process is exothermic process. Then we see the fourth type of enthalpy of physical changes. The fourth type of enthalpy of physical changes is enthalpy of dilution, which is represented by delta H DIL. Enthalpy of dilution means it is the enthalpy change takes place when a solution of one concentration is converted into a solution of another concentration by diluting it with water. Enthalpy of dilution, that is delta H DIL. Here, enthalpy of dilution is the enthalpy change takes place when a solution of one concentration on diluting converted into a solution of another concentration is called as enthalpy of dilution. It is the enthalpy change takes place when a solution of particular concentration changes to a solution of another concentration by diluting with water. It is the enthalpy change takes place when a solution of one concentration or particular concentration changes to a solution of another concentration by diluting with water at constant temperature and pressure. Example, when 1 mole of gaseous substance, HCl gas, passed into 50 mole of water, limited water, to form HCl with 50 mole of water, delta H1 is equal to -73.26 kilojoule per mole. This is the solution of one concentration. Second, when 1 mole of HCl gas is passed into excess quantity of water to form HCl aqueous, delta H2 is equal to -75.14 kilojoule per mole. Here, in first example, 1 mole of HCl gas is passed into limited water molecule, that is 50 water molecule. There is a formation of HCl aqueous solution with 50 mole of water. The enthalpy change is -73.26 kilojoule per mole. Then again, in second example, when 1 mole of HCl gas is passed into excess amount of water, that is large quantity of water, to form HCl aqueous solution, enthalpy change delta H2 is equal to -75.14 kilojoule per mole. Subtract equation 1, from equation second. That is second equation, HCl gas plus aqueous formation of HCl aqueous delta H2 is equal to -75.14 kilojoule per mole. Then first example, HCl gas plus 50 mole of H2O formation of HCl with 50 mole of H2O delta H1 is equal to -73.26 kilojoule per mole. During subtraction, changes the sign. Plus becomes minus, 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 and here plus. This HCl gas get cancelled. Then here, this minus HCl 50 mole H2O. On right hand side of equation, transfer it into left hand side, it becomes positive. That HCl with 50 mole of water and plus here aqueous. This aqueous, when we subtract the 50 mole of H2O on large quantity of water, there is no difference, no more change. Formation of HCl aqueous delta H dilution is equal to -1.88 kilojoule per mole. Here, the HCl with 50 mole of water, that is the concentrated solution, or one concentrated solution, by diluting with another concentrated solution, that is HCl aqueous, at that time enthalpy change is called as enthalpy of dilution, and that value is -1.88 kilojoule per mole. It means that when a solution of one concentration on a dilution converted into a solution of another concentration, heat is evolved. Therefore, this process is exothermic process. Once on a dilution, one type of solution into another type of solution, delta H is called as enthalpy of dilution. But on further dilution, this solution HCl aqueous, on further dilution, there is no change in enthalpy. These are the different types of enthalpies of physical changes. That is, first enthalpy of phase transition. Phase transition is phase transition classified into three types. That is, the first is enthalpy of fusion, enthalpy of vaporization, and enthalpy of sublimation. Second type, enthalpy of atomic or molecular changes, again divided into two types, enthalpy of atomization and enthalpy of ionization. Third type, enthalpy of solution, and fourth type is enthalpy of dilution. Here we stop, and then we start the next question.